Welcome back. The details were sketchy. The U.S. airstrike in eastern Syria last month was one of those news stories that left people more confused than informed. Damascus says four U.S. helicopters entered Syrian airspace from Iraq and killed eight people. Washington says the target was a senior al-Qaeda figure. What followed in the media was a series of claims and counterclaims with little in the way of evidence except for the pictures of the casualties. The Listening Post's Salah Kadar now on Syria, the U.S., the media, and the difficulties of differentiating between allegation and fact, truth and propaganda.
And we have some breaking news out of the Middle East we want to get to you. There's a report now that has just crossed by the Reuters news agency, which we have not confirmed.
Overseas now to Syria, and that government's accusation that the U.S. launched an attack inside Syria.
It's my understanding from sources here in the Pentagon that it would take approval at the highest level.
When does a report become a fact?
A Syrian website posted this video showing U.S. helicopters over Syria, but CNN cannot confirm its authenticity.
For many Western media outlets, reports out of Syria of the raid on October 26 were just that, unsubstantiated reports.
That story broke late in the day, and the Western media was being extremely cautious about it. They were talking about unconfirmed reports, but they kept on cautioning their reporting by saying that this raid wasn't confirmed by either the American military in Iraq or the administration back in Washington.
Numerous questions abound about the timing, purpose, and legality of the strike. But what troubles me the most is the way Western media covered the incident. Many Western media reports initially referred to the attack as alleged, even though Syrian television showed the gruesome images of the dead along with images of the helicopters.
They did report the story by actually telling what the Syrians have said, but actually by using keywords that put question marks actually on what the Syrians say.
Well, apparently it wasn't a precision attack because eight innocent people were killed.
According to the Syrians.
Well, they're bodies that somebody produced.
Whereas they take, the story from the American side as at face value. They're presented as facts.
For the Syrian media, however, the story and how to handle it was quite clear.
Syrian TV quickly showed pictures of destructions and of victims of this raid, and those pictures were picked up by most of the Arabic media, were shown over and over again throughout the night and into the next day.
Despite the fact that Western journalists have seen the pictures of the civilian victims, they actually went on trying not to believe that these pictures were original or these pictures were truly of those victims who have been killed in the U.S. raid. And that was, in my opinion, very insulting.
In the initial week after the attack, the Syrian media focused almost solely on the large number of casualties. What Syrian press did not report, however, was the fact that U.S. forces had been targeting a senior al-Qaeda official.
Fox News has confirmed this morning that the target of a U.S. special operations strike on the Iraqi-Syrian border was the leader of al-Qaeda in Syria.
Described as a facilitator for al-Qaeda in Iraq.
But for some outlets, the gruesome pictures and hazy camera phone video were not evidence enough.
You, of course, have the Syrian amateur video of the helicopters crossing Syrian territory in daylight, but what you don't have is the rationale behind it. This only came out in dribs and drabs, regrettably.
Do you deny that there was a U.S. involvement?
I don't have any comment beyond what I've given you.
So it's difficult for reporters, particularly if they can't get Western sources on the record to provide clarity.
I don't have any comment for you.
The Western media kept on alleging that the raid took place for two reasons. A, they weren't getting any kind of confirmation from official sources, whether again in Iraq or in Washington. And B, there is always that attitude of being cautious when it comes to what the Western media considers as rogue countries.
And the American government considers Syria one of these rogue countries. As questions continued about the raid and the U.S. incursion into Syrian territory, what did the American media do next? They asked the White House to explain what had happened.
There is a tremendous clamoring from reporters here in the United States looking for information, incredible information, about what happened.
You regard the reports as having even a scintilla of truth to them?
Regrettably, the White House press spokesman couldn't discuss this. And I think the wider question is, about the authorities in which this operation took place.
I am not able to comment on reports about this reported incident, and I'm not going to.
White House Press Secretary Dana Perino answered all the reporters' questions with a no comment.
You can come up here and try to beat it out of me, but I will not be commenting on this in any way, shape, or form today.
Faced with official silence, were the U.S. media guilty of ignoring the evidence or of self-censorship?
Since the so-called war on terror started, it has been extremely difficult for the Western media to ask the tough questions. There was this general atmosphere that the media should support the administration to avoid other 9/11s happening and certainly to fight against these bad Muslim extremist fundamentalists.
Most of the time, we feel like that the Western media is trying to frame the news in a way that favors the Western viewpoint of the story.
And that message, Charlie, is that if you don't control that border with Iraq, we will.
Emphasize it more, underline it more, and highlight it perhaps more in the news.
The Syrian government's grip on its media doesn't make for a climate in which journalistic integrity can thrive either. But could Western journalists have done more to inform their audiences and go and corroborate reports for themselves in Syria?
Well, Syria is an extremely complicated country to report from, even more so if you're a Western journalist working for a Western outlet. But in this specific story, the pictures were there because it was in the favor of the Syrian authorities to show these pictures.
I tried to do some reporting in Syria, and it's very difficult. It's not easy. Syrian TV is also a mouthpiece of the Syrian government and is heavily censored, which adds more complexity to the story.
I can't claim actually that the Syrian media is perfect because there is no perfect media in my opinion. But after all, what we have in Syria is a state-run media, and what is the main function of the state-owned media is to defend what the government actually says.
But one can still verify things by doing some real reporting for a change. You need to know your way around, and you need to speak some Arabic. Otherwise, what happens in Syria stays in Syria.